Sharon's here. Welcome to Wake Up Wednesday with Sharon and Nathalie. Today is going to be so much fun. We are going to talk about how to stop the peeling on your face when using Retin A. I've got some great tips for you girlfriends, okay? But before we get started, I want to tell all of you that have not subscribed to my channel, scroll on down, hit that subscribe button, and then see the little bell next to it, click that bell. It'll let you know of my upcoming videos. I generally film Monday, Wednesday, and Fridays, okay? What's a girl to do? We all, the majority of us, use Retin A, and the biggest complaint with Retin A is the suffering with all the peeling and the shedding of the skin while you're going through your Retin A phase. I have several suggestions for you because you all have asked me this, and we're going to get this down pat once and for all, okay? The one thing that we're going to talk about is the steps you need to take. The first thing I want you girls to do in the evenings is to wash your face. It doesn't matter which cleaner you use. Use the cleaner of your choice. Let's say you're using CeraVe, okay, a hydrating cleanser. That's fine. You could be using Cetaphil. You could be using any cleanser you would like. Cleanse your face just like normal. Then take your toner, alcohol-free toner I might add, and then it pulls your face back to its pH level. Wipe it all over your face with a cotton pad. Then after you do that, take your essence of choice. I used several essences. One that I grabbed was my Tatcha essence. I also used the SK2. I used the Time Revolution essence by, what is it, Misha? Yeah, any essence is good. I used to use the Rockhoop essence. Absolutely love that forever. It did have a little bit of alcohol in it, so I noticed it was a little more drying down the line than some of these others. Pick one that's going to be satisfying to your skin, please, alcohol-free, doing this step, please, okay? All right. So then now the essence, we put on one layer of essence with a cotton pad after the toner. Then I'm going to take my essence again, and I'm going to put some in my hand and just pat it on my hands and then pat it all over the face. Yes, you may drip. That's okay. Just pat, pat, pat. Push, push, push. Do the fingertip method. Do whatever you got to do. Get that essence in there the second time. Now you've got a lot of hydration on your face. The next thing to do is you're going to take a mask, any mask of your choice. Usually when I mask, I try to find something really uber hydrating because I have dry skin. So I may pull up a collagen mask, I may pull a hyaluronic mask. Sometimes I want my CoQ10 mask, whatever is your choice. It really doesn't matter. Choose the mask that you're going to love. Now, we all know that when I mask, I also put a silicone mask on top of these masks. I will list that down below. They're very inexpensive. They're like a light rubber silicone mask, and it just fits behind the ears, and it seems to hold my sheet mask in place a lot better. Plus, it applies more heat underneath, obviously, and I like my serums to feel like they're going into something warm, you know. Just like when you warm up your products, put everywhere else, I want warmth on that sheet mask going deeper into my skin. And then the next thing I do is I take my jade roller with my silicone mask on top of these masks, and I roll that jade roller up, and I do empty the lymph glands while you're at it, okay? So you go like this, and then you want to take it down the neck. I've showed you that in a video before. There's a certain way to do it. You just don't run it. You might as well empty out the lymphs while you're at it. No problem. Then you're sinking all of that serum in there. You're going to mask for about 30 minutes before you take your mask off. Then once the mask is completely off, oh my gosh, that skin is so beautiful and so hydrated and it feels yummy. Then you take your favorite eye cream, whatever it may be, and put your eye cream all under and around your eyes. You know, just pushing it in just like this. Taking care, doing your night care is what you're doing, all right? Then everything stops. Then what you do is you apply your Retin A, dot, 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 wherever you put it, and rub your Retin A in, okay? And leave it for the night. Because you already have toner, essence, and then you've masked, you have enough hydration for your Retin A. Don't put anything on top of the Retin A or it's canceling everything completely out. So leave it. Put your Retin A on. Go to bed. That's all you need. Go to bed. Okay? Now, when I had the mask on, a lot of the serums will go down my neck and décolleté. I just rub it on down. I mean, it comes out of the mask while your silicone mask is on, and I just sit there and I'm patting it in, pushing it in, pressing it in, tapping all over the place. You see what I'm saying? So whatever you do for your face, you've got to do for your neck and your chest. So you take care of all that. When you go to bed at night and you have put either your retinol or Retin A on your neck and chest, depending on what your choice is, all right, leave it. Nothing else on top. Nada. You've done what you need to do. Now, there are other ways that we can work on some of the shedding. Let's say during the week, if you don't want to mask and go through this whole routine every night, and you notice your skin is flaking, what I want you to do that morning is wash, tone, do your essence, then come over and take your polishing powder, your rice enzyme polishing powder by Tatcha. I use Tatcha. If you have another one that's like rice grains and it's very, very fine and it'll just polish the skin great. And then use that all over your face in the morning and then get dressed and use get your skincare and everything done like usual and get dressed and you're done. Okay? That will help with your peeling. The next thing that will also help with your peeling in the mornings is, remember I have told you before about Guerlain Naturals and their polishing cloths? These are heaven. And I stock up on these because I use them all the time. Now, if I get up in the morning, all right, before I do anything, wash or do anything, I start making circular motions all over my face with this polishing cloth. Down on my décolleté, my neck, up, over, down my nose, around my nose, everything. Do all this just because I want to put on my skincare and my makeup and have a smooth canvas with no flakes. That is another way to do it. My preference, because I, every single night, mask, that is the preference that I showed you a while ago. That is the way to go. One other method. A night after you mask, take your mask off. The next thing that you can do, and it is very, very effective, is to take your hyaluronic acid, even after you've done your essence, you've done your tone, you've done all that, you've peeled off your mask, ready to put on your Retin A. Before you put on your Retin A, use some hyaluronic acid. Take a little bit of that in your hands, rub it together, and pat all over the face. Wait, just about 3 minutes is all you have to do. Then you can apply your Retin A. That will also help. So ladies, these are like three different methods that you can be using all of this. And one thing I want to let you know is never, never, never put any type of moisturizer on top of the Retin A if you've done this other, because it'll cancel everything out. It would be too much. The effectiveness of the Retin A will go down. And as much as Retin A costs, and because it is the big gun of the medical grade arsenal, if you will, you do not want to limit the effectiveness of your Retin A. So just remember what I told you there. Nothing on top of the Retin A if you do all this moisturizing and hydration before. Do you understand? Now, let's say you're having a lazy night. Okay, God forbid, but let's say you do. and that you just want to wash your face and get it over with and put on your Retin A. My suggestion to you is to wash, that's cleansing, the toning, definitely the essence twice, just like usual. And I know you don't want to wait, but you're going to have to wait till it dries, 20 to 30 minutes, and then put your Retin A on. Okay, just like that. Now, on the other nights, when you are not using Retin A, this is a good way to hydrate. And after, okay, on a regular night, after you've done the cleansing, the toning, the essence twice, and you've put on hyaluronic acid, then put on peptides, put on your growth factor, then put on your nice heavy moisturizer. And then go to bed. Don't forget your eye cream. But right now we're going to talk about the peeling. So that's what you need to do. I've given you several ways now to take care of that peeling. And I promise you, I never, ever, ever peel. Ever. Now, whether it's a good thing or not, I will tell you this. When I use my polishing cloth, or when I am through with all my masking in the next morning, when I'm washing my face and wiping off everything with my washcloth, there is dry skin that comes off, okay? But as far as peeling all through the day and everything else, no, I don't. I don't, because I have my skin so hydrated, I don't go through that problem at all. And you won't either. So try it, girlfriends, okay? This is the best way to take care of the problem. I know you guys have been begging and begging me to tell you that system, and this is the system. So I will kind of list the steps a little bit for you down below. Okay, I'll put the wash and the cleanse and the tone and the essence and then the mask and then so forth and so on. But I think you guys will remember it anyway. I want to thank each and every one of you for joining me today. Thanks so much for being with Nathalie and I. And let's hop on over and see what Nathalie's got going on, okay? I want you to have a wonderful, wonderful week. And to all my new subscribers, thank you, girls, for being with me. It's so nice to meet you. I love you. And I want each and every one of you to stay sassy, classy, and confident. And give me a big thumbs up on this video.